Do you want your online store to be ultra-fast, fully customized to your needs, and scalable to more than 1 billion items? iMEOS is an ultra-fast PHP e-commerce framework. iMEOS, next level e-commerce. Try it now.
If you're running an application at scale, in public or private clouds, you have to tame almost boundless complexity. Datadog brings together all this observability data with infrastructure metrics, traces, and logs in one integrated platform.
Vonage is a cloud communication platform that lets you integrate voice, video, and messaging into your applications. We have a load of helper libraries, including a Laravel package and a client library for PHP. You can find out more about us at developer.nexmo.com.
Hello, Laracon. Thank you for watching my talk. I'll be talking about a real-time dashboard that I've recently made, and this dashboard is powered by Laravel, no surprises there, and also Livewire. For those that don't know me, I'm Freek van der Herten. I'm a partner and a developer at a company called Spacy. I'm active on Twitter, my handle is Freek Merze. I have a blog, freek.dev, where I talk about modern PHP and Laravel development. I've made an uptime tracker with a lot of whistles and bells called Odir. I've also built a self-hosted solution for sending out newsletters of any size called MailCoach. And together with Marcel, who's also speaking at this event, my team and I have built Flare, which is an exception tracker that is specially built for Laravel applications. Now, before diving into the talk, I want to say something about the open source efforts that my company Spacy makes. We now have about 250 packages registered on Packagist. They've been downloaded for 75 million times in total, and they are being downloaded for 4.5 million times a month. Probably we will reach 100 million downloads by the end of the year, which in my mind is quite amazing. Those packages that we make, you can see a big list of them on our company website. I'm sure there's something there for your next project. We also recently added a video section to our site where we explain how we work. Those videos, they provide a good insight on our best practices and how we like to do stuff. Now, a lot of these videos are sponsors first, so you can only see them if you become a sponsor of Spacy on GitHub, and I highly encourage you to do so. So, with that being said, let's talk a little bit about our dashboard. This is a picture of our office, and you see that there is a TV hanging on the wall and that displays something. Let's walk through the dashboard. And this is the content of our dashboard. Let's take a small look at what is being displayed there. So in the upper left corner, we have a Twitter feed with all tweets that mention our company. And at the time that I took this screenshot, somebody tweeted a cat at us. There's also a tile for each of our team member. And here it says, which task they should do this week. And I've removed the real tasks. These are obviously just dummy tasks. We have a clock. We have a weather forecast. We have some events here, which are fed by a Google Calendar. And these events, they are interesting for our company. Here we have some statistics on the bike sharing system that is active in Antwerp. Some of our employees, they come to our office by bike and they mostly use this bike sharing system. And here it says, like, in this station, there are 7 bikes available. And in the lower left corner, we have some statistics on our open source work. And that is our dashboard. Now, let's talk about how we have built this dashboard. So this dashboard, it is basically a package that we've made. And it's free and it's open source. And it takes care of the positioning of those tiles and also the styling and also the state of the tile. So it remembers the data that is displayed on those tiles. Those tiles themselves, they are packaged up. So they each are their own package and they are quite lightweight. You'll see that in a bit. I'll demonstrate this. And all these tiles, they are their own components. And they are not just regular blade components. No, they are live wire components. And for those of you that don't know what live wire is, let's give a very brief introduction. Live wire is an extraordinary package made by Caleb Porzio. And basically, this package allows you to build components with behavior that you might suspect, hey, I need JavaScript to do this. They can be animated, they can be refreshed without refreshing the entire page. And you don't have any JavaScript knowledge needed, or minimal JavaScript knowledge is needed to make this work. Those tiles, they get refreshed through polling. So every X amount of seconds, we refresh them. And Livewire will rebuild the DOM for that component on the server and insert and replace the old version of that component on the DOM with the new version. And yeah, it's just fantastic. If you want to know more about it, go to laravel-livewire.com. The docs are very good. They explain in very, very detail how you can work with the package. So with all of that theory out of the way, let's see a practical demonstration. Let's go to PHP Storm and the browser, and I've already prepared a Laravel application with the dashboard. So I've already pre-installed the dashboard into it just to save some time. So if I go to composer.json, let me make this a little bit bigger. Then you can see here that we installed the dashboard and also a couple of tiles that we can play around with. What I've also done is I've registered a route. I just point the root of the site to a view called dashboard, and the dashboard view is just empty, and that is what you're seeing here. Now, to get started with the dashboard, you should use X dashboard, the X dashboard's blade component. And that just sets up some general things behind the scenes. So this is the gray background of the dashboard itself. Now, this isn't very interesting. Let's put our first tiles on it. So Livewire powers these tiles. So it's Livewire colon and then the name of the tile. So maybe the time weather tile first. I'm going to position it on A1. And I'm also going to position another one already on C3. And then I can explain the positioning a little bit better. Let's refresh. And we get two time weather components. So how does the positioning work? So you should imagine the dashboard as being an Excel-like grid where each column is represented by a letter, so A, B, C, and each row has a number, so 1, 2, 3, and the dashboard just takes the space that it needs. So the highest row and the highest number is 3, so everything is divided in 3 parts. If I do like maybe D, then I have 4 columns, and then the horizontal space is split into 4. That's how that works. You can also have ranges. So if I want to make this a little bit wider, I can have a range just like you do in Excel. Oh, and I've made it higher. If I want to do wider, I should do A1, B1. And yeah, that's how that works. Now, behind the scenes, we translate these Excel-like coordinates to CSS grids classes. Let me show you that. And you see them here. And yeah, we just use some CSS grid magic to make this positioning happen. So that's how that works. Now let's put a more interesting tile on the dashboard, namely the calendar tile. Livewire colon calendar, and I'm going to position it in the middle, so from B1 to B3, maybe, like that. And I've made a typo, so this is calendar tile, I guess. Yeah, calendar tile. And let's just maybe use B1 here. Maybe that's enough. Yeah, and this is positioned right. Now, to explain a little bit of Livewire, I'm going to manipulate the view that renders this. So let me go to the the dashboard calendar tile. So I'm going to alter something in the package. So this is the view that is rendered to make this appear. And let's just add here to it. And it should be added here immediately, even though I didn't refresh the page at all. And if I put like a random string here, you can see that it keeps refreshing the whole time. Now, this is done by Livewire. And now the tile refreshes itself every 3 seconds. But under normal circumstances, it is only 1 minute a tile can decide it for itself. But I've moved all refreshing to a couple of seconds just to demo stuff like this a little bit easier. If I inspect the network here, we should see requests coming in for that calendar tile. And again, this is done by Livewire. This isn't done by, I haven't coded this up. If I go and I see what is in the response here, you can see here that we have a DOM key, and this is the rendered component again. So what Livewire will do is it will re-render the, it will poll components for changes. And we've set here a poll of 3 seconds. So every 3 seconds, Livewire will go to the server. It will say, hey, give me the HTML of this component. The server will render that. And Livewire will replace that new DOM. We'll replace the old DOM with the new DOM. And it will do that in a very efficient way with a library called MorphDOM, I believe. So that's how that works. So tiles can basically refresh themselves. Now let's take a look at where this data is coming from. So if I take a look at the database, we have a table here called dashboard tiles. And you can see here that the events that are displayed on the dashboard are in the database here. So these are just the same one. So you can see here, Larcon EU Online, Larcon EU Online. And this dashboard table is backed by a model called tile. And that tile model that is provided by the base dashboard package. So let me go to the base dashboard package. So it's Laravel dashboard source models tile. And it is a very simple model. It just has a static function. So you can create a row for a certain name. And that name, that is just the name of the tile here. And then you can just put data in it and you can get data out from it. And that's basically everything that this model does. And the goal of this model is to provide the tile packages a way of storing data. So let's go to maybe the calendar tile package itself, and we'll take a look at where we actually get this data and how it is being stored. So if I go to the calendar tile, you can see that the tile package is very small. It's only four classes. We have a command here, and it isn't that important that you know how it gets it from Google Calendar. It uses a package of ours to fetch those events. And it will get them all here in an events variable. So this is an array with all those fetched events in it. And we will pass it to a calendar store. Now, let's take a look at calendar store. And here you can see that calendar store, it is basically just a wrapper around that tile model that we just saw. When we construct the store, we just call that first or create for name, and we are the calendar tile, so we use calendar here. And in the command, you can see that we used this method, set events for calendar ID, and we're just going to put the data that we gave it, and we put it to the tile. So we save it onto the data attribute of the tile. That's how that works. And we also have a method of getting that data out of it, which we'll discuss in just a second. What we do here is, we get the data for the given calendar ID. And we will also manipulate it a little bit so that it is easier to display. These are basically like presenter kind of functions that live here on the store. So the store is just a wrapper around that tile. Okay, let's see what else we got in our tile package. We also have the calendar tile component itself here, and this is the class, the Livewire class that is responsible for rendering that component. Eventually, we will use a blade view to produce some HTML. Now, how does the package know that we should use that calendar tile component when we are using calendar tile? Well, that is being done in the service provider of the package. So here we have the boot method of the service provider, and here we basically just register the component. So whenever we use Livewire colon calendar tile, which we do here, we are going to use that calendar tile component here. So it has a mount function, and this is how you get data into a Livewire component. These things here, Livewire takes care of that arguments that that values are being passed to these. And where does it get that data from? Well, it gets them from the HTML attributes on the component. So position here, it is being passed to position here. You can see that we can also set a title here. So title, let's try it out, my events. Let's see if it, if we add it to this. And sure enough, we have my events here. Let's go back to the component itself. So I've said that we use a view to generate some HTML, and we pass to that view the events that we stored. So we use our calendar store here, and here we have that events for calendar ID, where we get the data that we stored in the data attribute of the model. Oh, made a misclick there. Let's go back. And maybe what is the next thing that we can do? Let's go back to the tile component. Let's take a look at this tile here. So let me open up the project structure. So that is this one. And this is the view that you saw me manipulate a little bit earlier, where I put the add the extra string here. Let's do that again. Maybe here in that loop. So here we have that for each event. So these are the events that we passed. And if I put something here in loop, then you can see that we are here. Yep, and there it refreshes. So these events, those are the events that we stored into the database. Let's remove that in loop and it's gone again. Let's see what else we need to discuss. So this blade view, it actually uses another blade component, namely X dashboard tile. And we give it the position and we give it the refresh interval. And X dashboard tile, that is a blade component that is provided by the core Laravel dashboard package. So if I go to the source, HTTP components, we see here dashboard tile components, and it takes care of like the refreshing and the positioning. So here you can see in the dashboard tile component that it gets that position and that refresh interval. And here you can see that we transform that position, so that Excel-like notation to those CSS grid classes that you just saw. That's being done by these functions. And that grid area, it is a public property, and public properties on a blade component, they will get passed to the underlying blade view. So the underlying blade view is this one, dashboard tile. And if I go to that one, so that is in the core Laravel dashboard, resources view tile, then you can see it here. So in case you don't know blade view components, the thing that is within the blade view tags, so the HTML that you wrote for your custom tile, it will be passed to slot here. So basically what we do is we add some more things to your component. We wrap some things around it. And what do we wrap around it? A div with a certain style. And that style, it has that grid area thing. So these are those CSS classes that we calculate. And that refresh interval in seconds, we use that here too. So this this is actually the HTML of a Livewire component, and how you can instruct Livewire to pull components and basically refresh and re-render components is just by adding wire poll to it, an amount of seconds followed with an S, stands for seconds, and that's basically all you need to do to invoke that behavior of Livewire. And we basically do that for you. The only thing that you as a package, as a tile package maker should do is, let me go to the calendar tile here. The only thing you have to do is just use our tile, just give it the interval you want, and we will take care of setting that that wire poll thing, and we will take care of translating that Excel-like position to CSS classes. So that's how that works. So that's basically the entire flow of how it works. Maybe let's add some new data to it. So maybe you can see it in action for what happens when a new event comes in. So here's actually the calendar that that has the events that are being displayed. So here I'm going to add a new event, or new event maybe, Hi Laracon, that's maybe a little bit more pleasing, like that. And if I now execute the command to get the calendar events, our tile should update with the new information. So now it gets the new information, it has written it to the database. Livewire will pull it and the new event gets here. So a final thing that I want to show in this demo is maybe another fun tile, and that is the Twitter tile. So we have a tile that can basically listen for incoming tweets that mention a certain string and display that. So let me show you that. So it's the Twitter tile. So let's refresh here to see if we have an empty tile. And how you listen for incoming tweets is also with a artisan command. I don't know it by heart. It's this one. So this one will actually open a tunnel with Twitter, and it will write everything that mentions spacy.be to the database. And yeah, this component will also refresh every 3 seconds. And when a new tweet is written in the database, it will be immediately displayed here. So I could tweet myself, but I think it's more fun to just call a buddy and ask for a tweet. Just let's call Nuno, see if he's available to help us out testing this thing. And there he is. Hey, Nuno, good evening. Uh-oh, I can't hear you, man. That is so unfortunate. I hope you can hear me. Okay. Nuno, could you send a tweet to me? And a tweet mentioning spacy_be. Okay, let's see if this works. I can't hear Nuno, but I think he can hear me, and I hope he will tweet something. Otherwise, we will need to do it some other way. And there we have the tweet. Hey, Spacy, your dashboard package is awesome. Hey, thanks, Nuno. Bye. See you later, man. Thanks for the assist. Okay, that was Nuno. A few technical problems, but maybe we'll solve it in editing. This is basically everything that I wanted to show you in this practical demo. Let's head back to the slides. So let's close off. Laravel Dashboard is an easy to use package, and you can set up a dashboard in no time. You've seen me add like a Twitter tile and a calendar tile in no time. There are actually a lot of user contributed things as well. Let me show you that. So if I go to the browser here, if I open up a new tab, here we are in the documentation of the dashboard, and here you can see our tiles, and there are actually quite a few ones contributed as well. The one of Vapor is pretty amazing. So this displays all stats from Vapor, and you can have this running in like a couple of minutes, I guess. It's just installing the dashboard using this tile, and then you can have this. Pretty cool. Let's go back. So we have an extensive documentation at docs.spacy.be. It's easy to create your own tiles. I've added a tutorial in our documentation, and there are a lot of community contributed tiles. Now there's one more thing that I like to say before I go. Laravel Dashboard isn't the first package that my team and I have created. Like I've said in the beginning, we've created more than 200 packages by now, and we think we have a very good workflow to do this, and we want to teach you that workflow. So we've created a premium video course called Laravel Package Training. In that course, you will learn how to build a package from scratch, and we'll cover framework agnostic packages and Laravel packages. We will use the best practices that we picked up while creating our collection of packages. We'll also put a big emphasis on how to test the package, and we'll also use GitHub Actions to run the test for various PHP and Laravel versions. In the course, we'll also dive into the source of various of our popular packages, so you can pick up some tricks that we use there. And in total, there's 4 hours of quality videos in there. So for the next couple of days, we will use the introductory pricing of $79. And just for today, we have a coupon code that gives you an extra discount. So visit Laravel Package Training to know more. And with that, we're done. I thank you for your attention. If you're interested in the dashboard, I highly recommend visiting this first link here. It contains a write-up of everything I've said during this talk and much more. See ya and have a great LaraCon.
Do you want your online store to be ultra fast, fully customized to your needs, and scalable to more than 1 billion items? iMEOS is an ultra fast PHP e-commerce framework. iMEOS, next level e-commerce. Try it now.
If you're running an application at scale, in public or private clouds, you have to tame almost boundless complexity. Datadog brings together all this observability data with infrastructure metrics, traces, and logs in one integrated platform.
Vonage is a cloud communication platform that lets you integrate voice, video, and messaging into your applications. We have a load of helper libraries, including a Laravel package and a client library for PHP. You can find out more about us at developer.nexmo.com. Yeah.